Hallo, hier ist Sascha von Short Review und ich präsentiere euch ein Interview. Im Rahmen des Ubisoft Events zum Game Mario & Rabbids Kingdom Battle sprach ich mit dem Lead Narrative Designer von Ubisoft Milan, Andrea Babich, über das Game und seine Entwicklung. Da der sympathische Italiener kein Deutsch sprach, ist das Interview in Englisch.
Okay, hello and welcome to the Mario & Rabbids Kingdom Battle Event here from Ubisoft. And I'm Sascha from Short Review, and with me is, please tell the audience who you are and what you've done for this game.
Hello everybody, my name is Andrea Babich, I'm from Ubisoft Milan studio, and I'm the narrative designer, lead narrative designer for Mario plus Rabbids Kingdom Battle. So I wrote the story basically for the game together, of course, with the creative director, Davide Soiani, and together with all the team, we worked at Milan, also in Paris and Montpellier, and of course with Nintendo, to create the best Mario plus Rabbids experience. It's the first time they meet together, they cross over, and well, I hope you like that.
My first play, and I see it's very crazy and funny, and how hard is this to find a funny scenario and combine this difficult, this different humor, more serious?
Yes. That's when a crossover comes together well, I think. When there is different kinds of characters, but they are complementary somehow. So the Nintendo heroes are, well, heroes, good-hearted, positive, sometimes clumsy, and sometimes a little bit weird, but still very sunny. The rabbits are crazy, are like 2 years old kids, so they just want to mess everything. So it's like, you know, when you do comedy, you need the most serious one and you need the crazy one to make the scenario happen. And that was very lucky for us, because writing for these kind of characters and working together, especially the fun part, was very easy.
It plays easy, it looks easy, but easy to create? I don't think so. It's hard to think easy.
Well, to unleash the creativity was easy. To contain it and to balance it, it was not easy at all, of course. We worked for more than 3 years and a half on the game, so it was a lot of work. A lot of work with Nintendo to get them their feedback. They are amazing at giving you feedback. We worked with the Rabbids creator. There was a lot of communication to get along. But at the end, I think everyone was very satisfied.
I find it interesting that you're Italian, so Mario comes home. Would you say this?
Thank you for noticing that. I mean, no one told me that, so I'm happy. It was very strange. We wanted to put a bit of this in the game. There are some in-jokes that Italian people will understand better, probably. And we have Rabbit Mario, and you know, we have the Nintendo characters and the Rabbit counterparts, so we have Mario and Rabbit Mario. And Rabbit Mario is much more the kind of Italian stereotype, which Mario is not. Mario is very, it's not a stereotype, it's like an Italian plumber. Rabbit Mario is a little bit more.
So you have a battle system, a battle world. How challenging is it to make a challenging battle system and a challenging battle maps for it?
That's huge. That part was very hard, and it was very hard to balance it, of course. Because what we wanted to create and needed to create was a so-called Mario experience. So a game which is easy to learn, but hard to master. So it has to be accessible, but it has also to have depth. You want to replay stuff, you want to improve your rankings in the battles. So to balance that was the level designers and game designers really put all themselves. Everyone is a super huge Nintendo fan at our studio, so for them it was the mission of life. It was not just, okay, we are developing a cool game, which is normal attitude. No, they really like, wow. We must give all ourselves.
There is so many battle games and multiplayer battle system. Is it hard to not to look at, to have to take from these games the best and, well, that's the way to take the best and combine it to a new game? but this is hard to not to copy too much and create something new.
Yeah, I think that inspiration always comes from passion and culture at the same time, let's say. So our team is a super huge fan of all the tactical games you can imagine in the war, from Fire Emblem to XCOM, everything. And yes, then you have to mix, but mix is not enough. You need to find your own key and your own signature moves. There must be something which only your game has. If you have that, you have some hope to just stand out, and people will say, okay, this is not just a copy or a Frankenstein and stuff, but there is something more. If I had to say, my personal, it's really a personal opinion. What shines in our battle system is the fact that in most tactical games, everything is really focused on the attacking in the best way with your weapons. So taking position and attacking with your weapons. In our game, even when you move, you can really damage or create new tactical possibilities for the players. Because you can, for example, dash the enemies while on the run. So it's not it doesn't count as an attack move. You're moving, but then you just, an enemy, you dash him. You can team up with a friend of yours, with another character. So your character can jump and do a team jump over another character. Even a double team jump, so Mario runs, jumps over Luigi, jumps over Rabbit Peach, then stomps over an enemy, stomp sign of the move of Mario, so you can squish him. This way of combining movement abilities really changes. Every turn creates some unexpected situations.
It's not so this stupid find a hideout and fire.
Yeah.
You have to think how to damage, how to think three steps forward. This is a very interesting system. What you say. And it's, you don't kill. It's not a kill game. It's funny. It's like the old, I don't know, the old classic board games.
Yeah.
This, we kick another out. So it's very interesting. So thank you for the few words for this great game, and it's Mario and the rabbits. What I say, we love them.
What can I say? I mean, I hope so. So August 29, the game will be out. So time will tell. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you very much.